The next one up on the board here is Minnesota 23, Wisconsin 19. Minnesota postgame win expectancy was 97%. Excuse me. Neither team could run the football. This was very strange to see. Minnesota had 75 yards rushing on 37 attempts. That is 2 yards per. And Wisconsin had 62 yards on 22 attempts for 2.8. The fact that Wisconsin only ran the football 22 times in this game and threw it 38 times tells you everything you need to know about this. Why in the world?
I gave out one public play. One public play, and it was Wisconsin minus 6.5. This is just the fitting end of the season.
It makes perfect sense. Graham Mertz, 21 out of 38, 171 yards, and an interception. Of course.
There's zero chance he can be the starting quarterback next year, right?
No, he can be the starting quarterback so long as you don't ask him to pass.
So there's zero chance he can be the starting quarterback,
but
right?
But Wisconsin hasn't needed their quarterbacks to really pass. Like
But when you need them to pass, if you get down by 10, it's ball game.
Yeah, pretty much. Wisconsin was up 10-6 at the half. There was no reason for them to throw the football as much as they did. They completely got off their script. Like, it made no sense. Tanner Morgan only threw the ball 16 times. He was 11 out of 16 for 199 yards. That's 12.4 per pass. Tanner Morgan was fine.
No, Tanner was fine.
But that's because he only threw it 16 times.
PJ Fleck took that coaching staff on the other side in that ridiculous-looking sweater, and they put him in a locker and just bullied the hell out of him.
I could not believe it. I will say this. Parker, that was on the show last week, he kind of called the Minnesota thing. He said, all the advanced numbers, all that crap, which it doesn't always work out, right? But in this one, he said, you know, I look at these numbers and I look at what they can make Wisconsin do, and they can make them uncomfortable. And if they do that, Minnesota can win this ball game easily. And he said, I'm going to take Minnesota plus the 7, you know, because when we recorded, the line was 7 at that point. And he said, everything shows that Minnesota is actually the better football team. And of course, I'm looking at it going, the Nebraska thing was fluky.
I just thought this was going to be a trench game. I just thought in the trenches, Wisconsin should physically be able to manhandle them. They would be too strong and they would be too big to move, to throw on, to run on. I was just wrong. Minnesota did anything they needed to do in the second half, and they made adjustments. The first half, Wisconsin did exactly what I thought they would do, which is slow this game to a hog and not let Wisconsin do anything. And then in the second half, it's just like, you're right, they threw the ball too much, which means their defense, they got off the field quickly. Their defense was on the field too long, and Minnesota just kept putting pressure on them and broke through and scored and scored and scored.
Yes, it was insane to see. Insane to see. But cheers to PJ Fleck. I mean, he got a massive contract extension. But
I said this in the middle of the season. I'm going to continue. I don't think Paul Chryst is a good coach.
It's starting to look that way.
I don't think that. And it didn't take this game for me to call that. This was, you know, 4 or 5 weeks back we had this conversation where I just thought he was getting out coached, because I think they have the talent to beat a lot of the teams that they're getting beat by.
No, but there's a reason why they were the favorite to win the Big Ten West. And
yes,
yet, here they go.
And they just don't look good.
Had to win this one, and instead they lose it, and Iowa is going to the Big Ten West title game. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter, at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com, or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.